We're back fishing again, Paul.
We're back, Robert.
Did you know this area is called the Desert of Wales? Because...
Because it's a desert?
No, because there's so few roads and so few houses and people.
Do you know what I'd call it then? And it's a much better, more poetic and alliterative name.
What?
The Wilderness of Wales.
The Welsh Wilderness.
It's much better, isn't it?
I mean, if either of us have medical problems, that's that, really. Whoa, what a little church.
I love a church, don't you?
Come on.
Come on. What is this, Bob? It's like a sort of Tracy Emin exhibition in there, isn't it?
There's a smell in the car, yeah?
There is a it's a bit fishy, actually.
It is. And do you know what I think it is?
It's car fish, isn't it? Pocket fish. Well, we've had pocket meats and...
I think it's... I got a bit of monkfish, oof, right? Yeah. And it was rancid.
Did you buy it rancid? Over here, Bob, I've got to go do a lovely deal on a bit of monkfish. Half price today.
I said, what's the catch? It's rancid. It's very cheap.
Here's the river, look.
Oh, it's quite calm, Paul.
This is a tributary of the Wye, the Irvine.
What fish are we catching?
I mean, we're hoping to catch a big chub. If we don't catch one here in the Irvine, yeah, maybe we will nip across to the main river, Wye, and see if we can get one there.
Tell me how we're fishing.
OK, so we're using a very simple method. Just touch ledgering, some people call it, or free lining, and we're going to use a bit of bread flake, right?
Rightio. Yep. Oh, the sun's coming out. A little bit.
Oh, lovely, isn't it, mate? Beautiful.
This is why we come, Paul.
It is. Certainly not to catch fish, is it? Good cast, Bob. Right.
The River Irvine, in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, we're tucked away here.
Tucked away, yeah.
I mean, the church has been a hideout for people.
Yeah.
Up until quite recently, people have hidden away around here, Bob.
Really? Have you got a place at home where you can hide away? You know, you hide in a cupboard or a pantry or something.
Oh, well...
Do you have anywhere you hide away?
No, have you? Well, who are you hiding from, Bob?
Well,
yourself?
Just for that sort of, like, we all need a bit of peace and quiet, so I've put a dart boards up right at the back of the garage.
Zen darts. No darts, just a dart board, isn't it?
I got a 180. A couple of weeks back.
What, in your mind or really?
No, I got a photo of it. Not that that proves anything, but...
Really?
Yeah. I'd like you to hide in the freezer. I'd like to see you frozen nearly solid so that I can chip... Come on, lad. See my arthritis in the arm.
Bloody hell. I get a little bit there, but that's very different to what you've got, isn't it?
This is the rheumatoid, the immune system one.
Ooh.
Yours is the wearing out.
Yeah. Well, I don't envy you that, mate.
I got it when I was about 27, 28,
right,
and had it for about 8 years. It's very debilitating.
Mm.
But I just woke up with it one morning, and then it went as quickly as it came. But
did
it came
you know
back...
what it was?
No idea. Thought it was my heart first. I woke up and I couldn't lift my head off the pillow because I had it in my neck and in your spine. But it just came back about 10 days ago.
Oh,
so I'm waiting for its story to unfold. Maybe it'll go.
Can you get it treated?
Steroids and stuff.
Right. Look at this. It's a perfectly formed one of these, isn't it?
Very nice. That would be a nice one to introduce the rice pudding onto the dinner table, wouldn't it? This one, though,
yeah,
is for when the roast beef comes out.
Go on. That's nice. Isn't this our sort of woodwind or...?
No, I was calling Ted.
It worked, didn't it?
Yeah.
Blimey, Ted, you responded. Go on. You two muppets.
How are you doing, Ted?
Are you looking for your briefcase?
Where's my briefcase?
Yeah. He has greyed up a bit.
He has greyed up, yeah.
Can get that done, Ted, you know.
The march of time.
Yeah. It's a shame, isn't it?
Do I look like a potato?
No, because you carry it off with the hat. The hat just saves you from potatohood. Oh,
King Edward.
Frying tonight.
Hello, King Edward, how do you do? Lovely to meet you.
Hey, by the way.
What?
It's Ted's birthday today.
It's not Ted.
I haven't got him anything, have you?
No, I've got
him. He hasn't mentioned it, so.
Maybe he doesn't want any fuss made.
Yeah.
We'll rationalise it like that.
Oh, we would never want a fuss, Ted.
No,
never want a fuss.
Is it really his birthday?
Yeah, 10 years old.
10? He don't look well on it, does he? What's that? Okay.
You could have been a model when you were young. You could have been.
Yeah, come on. Now hit me with the gag.
For a length of rope.
Not much action, Paul.
See, the problem is this river's been so low, most of the fish will have dropped back into the Wye. So I think we should be bold.
Yeah?
And go to the Wye.
Well, I'm never going to turn that down, go on
no,
the Wye.
You're not, are you? Even though it's high right now, we should have a better chance there. Come on, son.
Back on the river. The River Wye.
Ted's beating us to it, I've seen it.
Lovely.
Yeah, we've got a good chance of a chub in here, Bob. You jump in there.
Oh, down on the bank there?
Yeah, and I'm going to go off that croy over there.
See ya. Bon chance, Marie.
Tight lines, Marie. Hello, Ted. Bobby?
I'm just going to get us a cup of tea together, all right?
It's going to be a nice cup of tea, Bob.
Nice enough.
Yeah?
Yeah. Nice enough.
Nice enough is good. Thanks, Bob.
Whoa. Come and join me for a cuppa.
Come on, then. Beautiful.
Were you ever any good at small talk?
Yeah, I can do a bit of small talk.
All right, I'm someone, you're a stranger. How would
Hi, good morning, how are you doing? What's your dog called?
My dog's called Patrick, what's it to you?
Patrick? Oh, well, I'm just interested, you know. Mine's called Sheba.
I don't want to know what your dog's called.
Well, you're just practically a murderer, you are, aren't you? You're not just a nice little dog walker that I'm meeting.
I was so awful at it. I can remember in a group of strangers hearing someone mention football and think, that's it, in, go, Bob, go, Bobby, go. You can do it.
Yeah.
I can't do it.
Oh, know. I thought you were going to come up with an opening game, but you
barrier,
didn't.
That invisible.
Well, I don't mind it, Bob.
What about large talk? What's large
talk? I love large talk.
What's that?
Morning!
No, I think it's, full of facts, isn't it? Look, the graph's showing a medium of 42. That means we have to act now, and that's big talk.
That's a really keen politician, someone who's just come into office, isn't it? Ted, come and get a biscuit. There's a good boy. Come on, Teddy. Oh, hello. Hello, Ted. Hello, birthday boy. You all right?
Oh, the rain's coming, Paul.
Oh, God, it is, isn't it? Well, I was going to say, should we go and start fishing, but maybe we should just stay under here. What do you reckon,
Ted? No, we should fish on. Come on, we've got our gear.
I'm in.
Is it Chubbs?
Yeah.
Well done.
Don't mind, Paul. Oh, he's not bad, though, look.
Hey! Not bad at all, Paul.
Yeah, keep him in the water, Bob, there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ta-da.
There we go.
Look,
look
at the sun shining off.
I know, look.
It's like jewellery.
It really is like a jewellery. Isn't it, Bob?
Well done for Mr.
Look
Paul.
That, yeah. Well, not a bad shot.
And away. Well done, buddy.
Hey.
Our fortunes have improved.
Hey, how about that, Bob?
Yeah,
that was
great.
A decisive move, wasn't it?
Yeah, you've done really well. I need to get back
see
to the rod. See you around.
Bye-bye.
Oh! I'm in.
Bob's in. Look at you not winding.
Whoa, he's not ready.
No, he's not. Get him back out in the open again. Yeah. Oh, Bob, let that clutch. Don't wind anything, Bob. Please
I'm literally not doing anything. It's like I'm not here.
Lift your rod up. Right, if you can sort of just bring him backwards slightly now. And I've got him.
Boom!
Oh, there, look, there's a bigger fella,
thank
look.
You, Paul. Look at him.
Now, that is a chunky chub, mate.
That's a golden beauty.
It is, isn't it?
Whoa!
Whoa. That's a lovely chub, Paul.
Right, come on, get him back,
lovely, right, go on in, put him in there, nice and gently.
And away.
Hey, well done, Bob.
Oh, wait.
He's in.
I'm not quite in.
You're not quite.
My ass is in. Thank you. The wine never lets us down, Paul.
It doesn't seem to, does it, Bob?
Been wonderful.
Yeah.
But it's time for the accommodation.
Is it now?
And it's a good one.
Yeah, so you say.
Come on.
It's not one of your gimmicky ones, is it?
Or could you get that bag? Could you get the bag?
Yeah, okay.
Thanks.
This is the most remote place.
Are you frightened or full of anticipation?
No, I'm really scared. Hello.
Hello. See, that's your first job.
Is that it?
Yeah, it's called the Red Kite Barn.
I tell you what, it's amazing, Bob, isn't it?
Oh, I like it. This is exciting.
This is, isn't it?
Come on, leave the stuff. Let's just go and have a look.
Yeah, all right. Go on, Bob.
Here we go.
Come on.
Ooh.
Oh, hello.
His door. Ooh, it's bedroom, Paul.
Bob, you're so excited about a bedroom.
Yeah, but it's downstairs. It's one of those upside down business.
It's upside
upstairs.
Down house, isn't it?
Yeah, come on.
Oh.
Oh, it's nice. It's like open plan.
Cool, isn't it?
Isn't there something?
Yes.
We've got one of these old fashioned tellies, Paul, with steam, you know.
Oh, yeah, do you reckon you can work there?
Yeah, pump it
the
right
steam
up.
Telly.
And then the picture.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to sit down, Paul, rest my bones.
You look like you need to.
Do you sense that we're in the middle of nowhere? Do you get that feeling? I do.
Yes. Shall we see how long we can enjoy some silence for?
How do you enjoy silence?
Well, first of all, you start by being silent.
Yeah? And then how do you enjoy it?
Well, let's see what happens, shall we?
Oh. Ah. I'm going to go and check on Ted. He's making a right racket down there.
Move up, never gonna win a Royal Rumble. But when I come through, you know what I love to. I send shots for your team and leader. I make a witness decide to vacate. The war's getting sweet just like a Ribena. Yo, listen, yeah, that kid is in the jungle. Kid is in the jungle.
Paul, this is bad. I've got some terrible news.
What?
Ted is having one of his birthday parties down in the bedroom down there.
What?
Yeah. Will you go to it?
I'm not going to one of Ted's parties. I've been to him before. No way, Bob.
I went to his 8th.
Yeah, and I went to his 9th, and now it's his 10th.
I can't go, Paul. I've not recovered from the last one. Paul, look. I'll give you a game of buckaroo if you'll go to his party.
You are devious.
Come on.
Yo, yeah, that over, smelly aroma. Them done dead a really long time. When I ramp, when I skinny, couldn't wake from a coma. Yo, listen, yeah, that kid is in the jungle.
Morning, Paul.
Morning, Robert. What do you call that, breakfast?
I'm doing these poached eggs in a cup in the microwave. See if it works. We're surrounded by beeps in modern life, aren't we? My robot wife, she gets up in the morning. Beep, beep. Good morning, Robert. You look like a prince. I am so lucky to be with you. Oh, that's very kind of you, love. I do try.
That is so far removed from your actual life. Oh, God, another day with him.
I love you. Thank you so much for that trip to Bradford.
Thanks for a wonderful day in this beautiful city.
Could we go to Peterborough?
There you go, Paul. Microwave, poachy. What are you looking like that for?
Well, you know I'm looking like that. Look, that's a sort of waterfall of albumin.
That was the experimental one. That was 30 seconds. It actually needed 40.
Yeah. Right. So, shall we swap?
Do you want to swap?
Yes.
What's with your eyes?
What do you mean?
There!
What?
Did you go back to Ted's party after I went to bed?
No.
It's going to be a tricky day for you, Paul.
Oh. Well, anyway, thanks, Bob.
What do you think about here in the middle of nowhere?
Excuse me.
It's turned to chicken.
You poached it into chicken?
I poached it into chicken breast. Today I've arranged, Paul, for us to meet somebody called Dave Lyons. Mm-hmm. Who's the founder of Tackling Man?
Put him there. Put him there.
He's not a lion.
Oh, right, no, he's not a real lion.
Dave Lyons, who is the founder of Tackling Minds, which helps people with mental health problems via the gift of fishing. The NHS refer people to him. It's an alternative or complementary
therapy.
Yeah, so.
Oh, wow.
Come on then, shall we get going?
Yeah, I can't eat anymore.
Let's fish. Yeah.
Yep, come on in.
Another beautiful wide beach.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a lovely beach. Can we go on the beach?
Yeah, we can go down here, yeah.
Paul, look at this spot. It's magnificent.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm just going to fish with a bit of bread flake, like you did yesterday. Just touch ledger in, OK? Right. Hello, Ted.
You know, the Wye's still my favourite river, Paul.
Yeah, this is a lovely clean bit here, Bob, but there's still a lot of pollution in the Wye, you know. Agricultural pollution, problems with water companies, you name it, it's got it.
It's exciting, float.
It is, isn't it? Especially here, like this little pocket there, that there must be a few chub in there, mustn't there? Oh, was that a little knot? Yeah. Now, wait, 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 now, strike. Is that the bottom or a fish?
Fish.
Whoa. Don't wind.
I haven't wound.
Don't wind, Bob, that's a good fish.
It's massive fall.
I know it is. Don't mind.
Whoa! It's what's called a tugger. Did you see my technique?
No. Yes, I did. Never mind about your technique, mate. I'm sure I'm sensing some winding.
Can I apply for permission to wind?
No.
To wind?
You have to go through the Politburo.
This could be a clonker, Paul.
Could be. Raise the rod a bit. You can wind a little bit now. See what happens.
There he is. Did you see him?
Yeah, yeah, I saw him, yeah.
He winked at me. Come on.
There we go. Well, he's not that big.
He's not that big.
No.
He's a looker, though.
Oh, he is a looker.
Look.
Look at that, the burnished gold of a pristine, wild Welsh chub.
Chub. Chub.
Chubber.
Right, let's get him back.
OK, there we go. And away.
Through me legs, he nutmegged me. I've been nutmegged by a chub.
Chub, chubmegged. There's a ferocious eddy there, which will make life very difficult, Bob. See how fast it's flowing back upstream?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Very difficult to fly fish, really.
You'd have thought the trout would have gone in slower water. It must be quite an effort for them to rest in this sort of flow.
Well, they like to lie, really, just off the current. I mean, the current's coming back upstream here, look.
I quite fancy that they might be facing that bit.
You think they're facing that way?
Yeah, maybe.
Well, they might be. I'll have a few casts under the tree, but it's quite tricky. Yes! Whoa!
Paul, man, you genius!
Well, you said facing that way, Bob. I said they would be, but you made me do it.
Well, what a bonus! Bloody hell!
Oh, that's great, isn't it? He's not ready yet, mate.
Oh, that's amazing, Paul.
Yeah. Well, look at it. It's so weird,
like
fishing
a wild
backwards.
Trout.
Yeah. Get your net in. That's it. Get down like that. Oh, look, there he comes. He's a beaut, look. Go on. Yes!
That is amazing!
Yeah, but that's proper teamwork, Bob.
How about that?
Yes, brilliant.
That is so special, Paul.
Beautiful, a little wild, white.
Hi, Paul.
Look at those spots.
Wow.
Look. And then we'll point him upstream.
And away.
And away.
Well done, Mr. Whitehouse.
Cheers, well done, mate.
Incredible. Yeah. Did it put a smile on
your face? It took a sideways mind for me to fish backwards, didn't it?
Wow. Yeah. You know. Paul, I've had a text, yes it is. Dave is here by the rocks, I presume he means over there. You gonna come and have a word?
Yeah, I'd like to meet Dave, yeah.
So Dave, are you the owner, the CEO of Tackling Minds?
That sounds very corporate, doesn't it?
Yeah, doesn't it?
The founder.
Right.
I formed Tackling Minds because of my own struggles with mental health and past addiction issues.
Right.
And I found fishing more therapeutic, more beneficial for my mental health than any therapy, any medication I'd took in the past. So I wanted to share that knowledge and help as many people as possible, which we are doing.
Do you think it's a sort of, strangely, an addiction in its own right?
Yeah.
It really does sort of empty your mind of a lot of negativity.
Yeah, of course. And it's great to put your mind to a different output.
Yeah.
You know, you might be wallowing in yourself or whatever it may be, but yeah, fishing gives you that focus.
And what's the sort of size of it, Dave? Do you take a group of people who are struggling every week, every day?
It's as simple as people go to the GP, and the GP can refer them to come fishing with us. Our groups are around 6 participants at a time. Yeah.
All right.
The fishing's sort of secondary as well at times, you know, when you're getting out and the camaraderie you get between the service users. And yeah, we cast a line on. Make sure we catch plenty of fish and everyone goes away, you know, with a huge smile. And you can just, you see the benefit everybody gets from every session.
But a lot of people, I presume, will still be on medications and it's...
Yeah, we always say it's an alternative to medication, but also to complement medications and therapies as well, so...
Yeah. I'm going to leave you two to chat.
You're going to fly fish, then?
I'm going to go and carry on fly fishing. I might go... I'm going to head off upstream.
See you later,
Dave. Lovely to speak to you.
Do you know, Dave, in your line of work, some people who care a lot for others can neglect to care for themselves, guilty or not guilty.
100%, yeah. When I was at my lowest, for sure, yeah.
And so it's your therapy as well?
Massively, yeah. Yeah. You know, I don't think I would behave if it wasn't for the fishing.
You don't think you would be? So what's your journey, Dave?
I've struggled with alcohol addiction for a number of years. I'm 2 years sober now. I used to self-medicate because my anxiety was that bad and alcohol was my crutch, unfortunately. I'd been on so many different types of medications, different therapies, and fishing was far more therapeutic, beneficial for my mental health and my recovery than literally anything else, hands down, that I've tried.
Right. Has it meant that you've been able to come off medication?
Yeah, I'm off medication as well now. I don't think with mental health, like my anxiety, I don't think it's something you can fully get over. I think you sort of learn to manage that, but with the fishing, 100 times, it's helped it, like, beyond belief.
Yeah. I know you wouldn't say it, but you must be very proud of what you've done.
Yeah, I
must be.
I'm,
should be.
Do you know what I get from it is my parents are so proud.
Right.
Choking up there.
Yeah.
My parents are proud. What?
Oh, brilliant, brilliant. Because, yeah, we've all gone through periods where we've let our parents down, and on reflection, it's very cruel, isn't it? It's very cruel.
Yeah. But, yeah, just happy I can make my family happy now as well.
Yeah. Well, it's a privilege to talk to you, Dave. It's amazing meeting people who've actually made the decision to try and make a difference to help other people. And I'm really pleased that your parents are proud of you. That is great. Thank you, Dave. Well done. Nice one. Dave was great.
Was he?
He's gone through his bad times, he's come through the other end.
Yeah.
It's lovely to hear someone doing that, you know. It's inspiring. Actually, do you know what, Paul? I think I'll have one little last go, yeah?
Go on then, you dafty. Do I have to watch this?
Well, if you want to learn, yeah.